Hallelujah. We are welcome to our prayer response to the challenge we have in the society, the pandemic. Today, we want to pray specifically for our health workers, the frontline workers, the doctors, nurses, the caregivers. So if you are a doctor, be rest assured that we are praying for you and want you to join us. You are a nurse, you are a caregiver, or you know a nurse, you know a doctor. When we are praying for the health workers, we are praying for ourselves. This evening, we want to use some Bible verses to call on God, because he said in the time of trouble, we should call him, he will answer. 2 Timothy chapter 1, verse 7. Say, for God had not given us the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of sound mind. So join us as we pray for our doctors, for our nurses. If they had fear and have abandoned the work, the confusion would be much. So glorious God, we thank you. We thank you for the gift you have given us through our doctors, through our nurses. Father, we thank you. And you have not given them spirit of fear. You have given them spirit of power, of love for the sick. The power of sound mind, the gift of sound mind. Father, we thank you for the sound mind you have given to them. They are not confused when the patients are crying. They are not confused when the patients are talking of pain. They have sound mind. Father, we declare that this year gift will be made manifest in our doctors, be made manifest in our nurses, and all the caregivers, all the frontline workers. Father, we thank you for their life. We thank you for the gift you have bestowed on them. Every spirit of fear, we banish from them in Jesus' name. Every spirit of fear on our doctors, fear that their patients will die, fear that there is confusion, fear of attack. Father, we come against the spirit of fear in Jesus' name. Father, we thank you for the release of power. You have given power as a gift to them, and we declare they will use the power, they will use the authority, they will attend to their patient with the hope that they will recover. Father, we thank you. We thank you for the gift of love, that our doctors will love the patient, our nurses will love the patient they are taking care of. Every caregiver, we attend to their patients in love. Father, we thank you. Love is a gift, and you have released it unto us. Father, we say that our caregivers, our doctors, we practice this love. It will flow from them to their patients in Jesus' name. Father, we ask for sound mind. This is the gift you have given. The doctors will not make mistake. The surgeons will not make mistake. The nurses will not make mistake. Drug prescription, medicine prescribed will be in order. When it's been dispensed, it will be in order. Father, we thank you for sound mind. Panic will not be their portion. Father, we thank you. We thank you this day. We thank you because victory is yours. You know of all the things we are passing through. That's why before now you have released gift of power, gift of love, gift of sound mind. It is the portion of our doctors. It is the portion of our nurses. It is the portion of our caregivers. Father, we thank you. All of us must in one way or the other have contact with doctors, have contact with nurses. So as we lift our doctors, we are lifting every family unto you. Anyone that gets in contact with doctors will not be afraid. Will not be afraid of meeting a doctor. Will not be afraid of meeting a nurse. Father, we thank you for your love. Let your name be glorified. Hallelujah to your holy name. In Jesus' name we have prayed. In Proverbs 21, verse 31, he said, the horse is prepared against the day of battle, but safety is of the Lord. If you go to the hospital, you see the doctors wearing their safety gadget. See the nurses wearing their safety gadget. But inside them, they know all these things is not the saving issue. Safety is of the Lord. So let's lift all the nurses, all the doctors, all the caregivers, all our health workers unto God, that their safety is of the Lord. Father, we thank you for your promise. that their safety is of you, that they may be prepared against risk, prepared against anything. But according to your word, you say the horse is prepared against the day of battle, but safety is of the Lord. Father, we thank you. The nurses are secured. The doctors are secured. All the caregivers are secured. Father, the fear of contamination, the fear of carrying virus disease from the hospital home, we reject it in Jesus' name. Father, their safety is of you. When they know that they are secured, fear is banished. So, Lord God, we thank you. We thank you that our nurses are secured. Our doctors are secured. As they're going to the hospital, they're going with hope. They're going with clarity of mind. They're going that nothing will happen to them. Father, we thank you. You promised safety, and safety is of you. Safety is of Jehovah. Father, we thank you. We pray of every nurse, every doctor. They are people in the ministry of touching life. Father, save them. Secure them. Father, we thank you. You say our life is hidden in Christ in God. So we ask that the life of doctors, as they leave their home to their offices, Father, let their life be hidden in Christ in God. Let them know that their safety is assured. Father, we thank you for their safety. We thank you for the safety. We glorify your name. Hallelujah to your holy name. Thank you, God. Father, we are assured we will not hear bad news concerning doctors going to the hospital to get sick, to get infected. Father, they are going there to save life, to be vessels in your hand, to touch the weak. Father, we glorify you. Hallelujah to your holy name. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. Psalm 41, verse 1. Psalm 41, verse 1. He said, blessed is he that considereth the poor. Blessed is he that considereth the poor. Said, the Lord will deliver him in the time of trouble. All the people going to the hospital, they are people that are poor in their health. They are poor in their health. Some doctors will leave their personal issue because they want to give consideration to the poor in health. And the word of God we have read said, blessed is he that give consideration to the poor, that the Lord will deliver him in the time of trouble. So there are two prayer points here. We bless our doctors, bless our nurses, then we ask God to deliver them in any form of trouble. Father, we thank you for your word. You cannot promise what you will not do. You are a faithful God. You say, blessed is he that giveth consideration to the poor. The doctors are giving consideration to the people that are poor in their health. The nurses are helping them. Even people that cannot walk, they will carry them. Father, we thank you for the work they are doing. They are cleaning up the sick. Lord, we thank you. They are blessed. You, doctor, you are blessed. You, nurse, we say you are blessed. We declare the blessing of God in you, the blessing that have peace, the blessing that will give you the peace that pass all human understanding. It is your portion in Jesus' name. It is your portion in Jesus' name. We key in with the word of God that you are blessed. Anyone God declare blessed is blessed. For you to give consideration to the poor, the blessing of God is upon you. The blessing of God is upon your family. The blessing of God is upon what you do. You will get result. When you touch the sick, you will have result. Father, we thank you for the blessing you are releasing upon the health workers. Father, they are going to their workplace with confidence that they are a source of blessing. Father, we thank you. They are blessed in the morning. They are blessed in the noonday. They are blessed at night. We leave them unto you. They will not walk in vain. Father, thank you for your blessing. Your blessing will flow from their life to anyone they touch. Glory be to your name, Lord. Father, we thank you. You say you will deliver him. You deliver them in time of trouble. Father, our doctors are human. The nurses, they are human. The caregivers, they are human. Father, they will have time of trouble. But Lord God, we declare they are not alone. We leave them in line with your promise that you will deliver them in time of trouble. Any time of trouble, a caregiver is passing through even right now. I speak deliverance unto you. The deliverance of God is your portion in Jesus' name. The deliverance of God is your portion in Jesus' name. The word of God to the Israelites when they first Red Sea,
If through Moses, he said, the Egyptians you see today, you see them no more forever. I declare unto you that the trouble you see today, you see them no more forever in Jesus' name. You doctor that is troubled, yet the sick is troubling you. You are attending to them. That your trouble is settled in Jesus' name. You nurse, your trouble is delivered. You are delivered from your trouble in Jesus' name. We join you to declare the blessing of God, that God will fight your battle. You will have peace. Father, we thank you. We glorify your name. We magnify you on behalf of all the health workers. We glorify you. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah to your holy name. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Amen. We want to pray for the family members of the doctors, the nurses, the caregivers. As they go to work, sometimes the family members will say, what if they catch the virus? They will bring it home. It will not be their portion in Jesus' name. So, Lord, Father, we lift every member of a family that have a health worker. Father, we lift them unto you. Father, their safety is of you. Their safety is of you. Father, they are going out and they are coming in, they are sealed. Father, fear is banished from their life. As the doctor member of the family, nurse member of the family is coming home, they will be excited. They will not be afraid. Father, we thank you. We thank you for your safety. There is comfort at home. There is peace at home. Every nurse, every doctor, we declare peace in your home in Jesus' name. We declare peace in your borders in Jesus' name. Your children will not be a trouble to you. Father, we thank you for peace in their home, peace in their relationships, peace in their marriage, unity in their home. Father, we thank you. Their children will be among the best in their schools, in what they do. We glorify you. We glorify you, God. Father, we magnify your name. Hallelujah to your holy name. Be thou glorified. Be thou glorified. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We are delivering their family from every form of disease, every form of infection, every form of attack. You are delivering their family. Father, we thank you. We thank you. When they are leaving home to their office, Father, they know that their family is not abandoned. And their family, they will know that the nurse, the doctor have not abandoned them. Father, they are going out in the mission field to touch the sick, to heal the afflicted. Father, their family is safe in Jesus' name. As they take care of the sick, Jehovah, take care of their families. Take care of your families in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah to your holy name. Be thou glorified. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Some people will go to hospital, and instead of healing, they will come home with trouble because of error by nurse, by doctor. But today, as we are praying for the doctors, I will pray for the nurses. We are praying for anyone that will visit the hospital. Father, we ask that the excellence of spirit, the wisdom from you, be released to the doctors, be released to the nurses. They will not operate in error. None of them will operate in error. Father, they will not operate in error. Father, we thank you. We thank you. We pray that their hand will be a healing hand. Father, their mentality, they will use it to heal the sick. Father, when they listen to the sick, you give them wisdom of understanding. They will not trust only on their experience. They will trust on the wisdom you will release to them. You say wisdom is the principal thing. Wisdom is the main thing. We ask for wisdom for the nurses, wisdom for the doctors, wisdom on how to attend to the sick. When the sick is in pain, wisdom to interpret it. When the sick is crying, wisdom to interpret it. When the sick is not even talking, cannot talk, wisdom to understand them. Father, we ask for your wisdom. Release your wisdom to them in Jesus' name. Release your wisdom to them in Jesus' name. Father, we thank you. We glorify your name. Thank you, Jehovah. Hallelujah to your holy name. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Amen. The word of God said, have you seen a man diligent in his work, diligent in his skill? His gift will bring him before kings, before the noble. So let's pray for the nurses, the doctors, that their gifting will bring them before kings, before nobles. Father, we thank you. We glorify your name. We thank you. We glorify your name. Father, the giftings you are giving to the nurses, the doctors, as they walk, they are walking as though unto you. You say, anything we do, we should do as unto the Lord. Father, and you said, lifting, promotion, cometh not from the east or west. It cometh from you. As the nurses and the doctors are doing their work, Father, let their gift make way for them. Let their gift bring them before kings. Let their gift bring them before nobles. Father, let be the one to advertise them. Father, we thank you. We glorify you. You say, we will not build and another occupy. Father, as they work, Lord, as they do their work diligently, surprise them with your blessing. Surprise them with your blessing. Promotion from you, Lord, is their portion in Jesus' name. Promotion from you, Lord, is your portion in Jesus' name. Father, we thank you. Give them reason to rejoice. Hallelujah. Give our doctors reason to rejoice. Give them reason to go to the work the next day. Father, give them purpose to go to the work the next day. Give them reason to answer emergency call. Father, as they do the work, grant them peace. Grant them the joy that pass all understanding. Let their expectation be fulfilled. The expectation that the sick will not die, that there will be recovery. Father, that will be their portion in Jesus' name. Father, we declare to you, nurse, you doctor, it is well with you. It is well with your family. It is well with your children. It is well with anything you lay your hand to do is blessed. We bless you in the morning. We bless you in the noonday. We bless you in the night. It is well with you in Jesus' name. It is well with you in Jesus' name. The word of God told us, say, God, you see, I will fight your battle. I will fight and you enjoy peace. We declare you are a human. Every battle of life, battle of finances, battle of marriage, battle concerning your work, how to relate with your supervisors. Father, we declare, take over. Take over the battle. Let there be peace in their home. Let there be peace in the workplace. Let there be peace in their relationship. That day we enjoy peace. Father, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. You, doctor, you will enjoy peace. You, nurse, you will enjoy peace. You are going to the war front as though you are going to the war front. That's why we are calling you the frontline workers. Father, you have not decided to resign because of fear. You are doing it because you want to save life. God will fight your battle. God will fight your battle in the morning. God will fight your battle in the noonday. God will fight your battle at night. It is well with you in Jesus' name. It is well with you in Jesus' name. You will enjoy peace that passes human understanding. That fear of yesterday is no more. That fear of yesterday is no more. Fear concerning your career. Fear concerning your family. Fear concerning your health. Fear concerning the patients you are taking care of is banished in Jesus' name. You will be filled with joy. Joy to testify of the goodness of God. Hallelujah to your holy name. Father, we thank you. We glorify your name. The word of God says, when we pray, God says, he will answer even more than we have asked or thought of. This day, our thought is unto you, doctor, you nurse, you health worker. Our mind is on you, that it will be well with you. God knows what you are passing through. So we are lifting you unto God, who knows the end right from the beginning. Father, we thank you for all the health workers. You know them more than we know them. Even know them more than they know themselves. Those working in the east, in the west, in the north, you are omnipresent God. You know where they are right now. You know the pain they cannot tell anyone. But people going to the hospital are going to tell them problem. No one is going there to listen to their own problem. But Lord, you search the heart. Father, hear their cry. Hear their pain and heal them. Hear their pain and replace it with peace. Lord, we thank you. We glorify your name. When we hear their testimony that there is a transformation. Father, we hear their testimony that their hand is a hand of healing. Father, we hear their testimony that it is not by experience, but by your own intervention. Let your name be glorified. Hallelujah to your holy name. Thank you, Jehovah. We glorify you. We thank you. We thank you. We thank you for blessing the doctors and blessing their family. I'm blessing everyone that we visit the doctor. You, doctor, anyone visiting you this day, anyone visiting you will be blessed. Anyone visiting you will receive solution. You are a source, a channel of solution. It is well with you. It is well with your family. It is well with your patients. God be glorified. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for hearing us. We are glad that you will hear us. Is there anything we ask in Jesus' name? That will you do, that our joy may be full. All the prayers we ask is because of the privilege of the name of Jesus. We receive answer, and our doctors, our health workers, we glorify you. Hallelujah to your holy name. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Amen. Hallelujah. I believe you have joined us to pray. And when we pray with understanding that God answers prayer. God has answered us. We will be glad to hear your testimony, especially the testimony of peace, how God has banished fear from your life. It is well with you, doctor. It is well with you, nurse. It is well with you, caregiver. Every health worker, you are secured in the Lord. We bless you in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.